volley of gunfire in central Paris.
Shalom, covering the mind. Stephen Ben Danoon, you're watching Israeli News Live. We here in, over in France, there again is unrest, more killings, more targeted Jews by terrorists, by Arabic terrorists in this particular part of the world. We're not very far from France, and this afternoon there was a report in the France 24, which is a news agency, www.france24.com. It is an English publication, online publication, news source for France. It says Charlie Hebdo suspects killed several hostages, die at the Paris market. It is, by the way, that is a kosher Jewish market where these hostages were killed at today. Two of the suspects that were in the Charlie Hebdo attacks were killed in a shootout with police Friday evening, that was just hours ago, northeast of Paris, while at least four people died in a second hostage crisis at a kosher Paris market. We have on here, French police launched an assault Friday on the two Charlie Hebdo's shooting suspects' brothers, Sharif Kachi, 32, and Saeed Kachi, 34, reportedly killing both. A hostage the men were holding at a printing shop in the town of Demartin and Goel, around 12 kilometers from the Paris main airport. Charles de Gaulle has been released and is unhurt. Police also stormed a kosher supermarket in eastern Paris, releasing several hostages who were held there by a gunman. The hostage taker, who is reported dead, has been linked to the fatal shooting of policewoman in Montrouge, of southern Paris on Thursday. In a televised address late Friday, French President Francisco Hollande said four hostages had been killed in an appalling anti-Semitic act. It's very interesting that the French Prime Minister is willing to state that it is an anti-Semitic act. We can only imagine that if this is happening in Paris, France, that more attacks, no doubt, are being planned by Arab terrorists around the world. These attacks seem to run simultaneously around the world, so we'll be watching to see what may develop where and when in other countries. Of course, France, as people that may not know, is very much open to the Muslim community, bringing in Muslims and helping them become citizens in this part of the world. It is also a nation that is very anti-Semitic towards Jews, period. And that's not just the Muslim population, that is also with a lot of the youth of France as well. So we've seen a lot of issues that happened with the French here in recent months, the different attacks on Jews. And so therefore, it is a volatile spot for the Jewish people nonetheless. Not to mention the different problems that are going on in Israel, constantly with the different groups there. And by the way, one of the attackers had claimed to be part of ISIS that was in this attack in Paris. So very, very sad situation there for the Jewish loss of life. Also in Israel, the Arab that had stabbed the Jewish man in the back with a screwdriver, a 15-year-old Jerusalem Arab, was nabbed on suspicion of stabbing a Jew in the back of the Old City, wounding his lung. He has been arrested. Jerusalem District Police earlier Friday afternoon arrested a 15-year-old Arab resident of the capital who is suspected of stabbing a 21-year-old Jewish yeshiva student in the night before with a screwdriver. The Arab suspect, a resident of northern part of Jerusalem, was located on Haggai Street in the Old City and arrested with the assistance of Border Patrol officers. He was brought in for investigation in the attack, which occurred at the Old City's Damascus Gate. The victim was stabbed in the back as he returned from the Kotel Western Wall. Dr. Ofer Marin, Deputy Director General of Sher Sadiq Hospital, head of the trauma unit, told Arud Shiva about the stabbing. That's how the story was first brought to the attention of Arud Shiva, Israel National News. So just very serious issues going on in Israel and around the world. Hamas terrorists in Israel are switching to ISIS. That's another big issue there. A lot of the Hamas terrorists are actually joining up with ISIS. Another article in Israel's national news says, as new details are revealed in the investigation of the Islamic State ISIS terrorist cell in Hebron, security officials estimate that hundreds of Hamas terrorists are leaving the moderate terrorist group in favor of ISIS to wage war on Israel and the Palestinian Authority. The leader of the Hebron ISIS cell, Amid Wada Salah Shihab, 22, admitted under Israel's security agency investigation that he switched from Hamas to ISIS in recent years because it was too moderate for him and that Hamas didn't compel Sharia Islamic law, reported Channel 2 News. I'm Stephen Bendenu. You're watching Israeli News Live. Shalom and good evening.